Hey, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a 2014 LEGO Star Wars set. This is the Vulture droid, and it comes with 205 pieces. When I left the movie theater after watching Episode 1 the first time, the things that stuck in my mind were, of course, Darth Maul, Darth Maul, and Darth Maul. Also, I want to kill Jar Jar, I want to kill Jar Jar, I want to obliterate Jar Jar. Other things that stayed in my mind? Well, the rolling droid decas, and then these things, the Vulture droids. They were very interesting to me because they are ships that are robots themselves, and they also transform. So they go from the starfighter form with an interesting design to them, and then they'll actually turn into walkers. So LEGO has done these before. It's just another newer version. Let's go ahead and take a look at how it transforms into a walker. Well, there's the first step. Put it on its nose. Then these bits actually spread and open up like that. That's good. Do the same thing over here. That's good. You can rotate the entire body a little bit forward, which is appropriate. And then you can take this entire head and bring that out. And you can place that wherever you want. You can keep it in close, or you can bring it out farther. You know, it's got the kind of eyes on it, so it looks like its head. It looks a little bit, well, I mean, they call it a Vulture droid because of this form. You know, it's supposed to have a long neck and then a long pointy head. And there you go. It's in its walker form now. And you can rotate these around a little bit, get a little bit of articulation there. You can rotate these a little bit, get a little bit of articulation there. And to walk it, well, you can do this. That's about it. It actually doesn't walk. You don't have any ability to pivot the legs forward and backward. So that's it. And you'll notice back here, you have a big open space and there's a console there. And that's actually a spot where you can put your pilot battle droid, which is included in the set. You know, it's a pretty simple spot. New sticker just for this set, but nothing too fancy. And that's pretty much what you get here. Oh, except for one thing. Put it quickly back into its starfighter form. That is a laser bolt. You can load that up in there. That is another laser bolt. You can load that up in there. And this uses the new 2014 spring-loaded 1x4 brick that will shoot things. So you've got dual lasers inboard. It's too bad they couldn't get them to shoot from out here, you know, which would have been more realistic, but it's okay. It's at least they have a pair of them in there, and those just stick out from the back, and to shoot them, you just pretty much just push on them anywhere, and off they go. A lot of power, very straight. Wow, look at that, ricocheted right back onto me from the back of the wall there. Powerful things, new red color. They actually give you three of these in the set, so you have one to spare. And yeah, just one extra little action feature for the kids that want to play with this. So there's your pilot battle droid and a new model for 2014, a Nemoidian warrior who's thrown in here. I feel like a little bit at random. You know, it's not the best fit for this particular set. You know, they're on the same side, so you don't end up having anything to shoot at with this set. Could have been, I don't know. I just feel like it's a little bit random, but yeah, you can take a good look at the prints on his torso, front and back. He only has one face, so no alternate there. And the pilot battle droid just has a blue, standard blue color of a main torso with a little bit of a creamy colored, actually it's tan, print on the front. This is a new design for 2014, and this is a perfect random thing to throw in with this set. It's a buzz droid, and you would see plenty of these being deployed out there in the space battlefield with Vulture droids swarming around. So this is great to include. You've got these printed 2x2 rounded pieces, and it's got its little saw, little buzz saw in the front. This is really adorable. I think this is really nice with the little lever legs for it. The whole thing is built around one of the new 2014 generic blaster core pieces there. You can see the handle of the blaster there, and it's too long. It's like a 1x2 by not quite a full height. I think it's a two-thirds height on it. It's got studs all over the place, made for a perfect base for building one of these things. A simple build, not a whole lot of pieces used on it, but it looks really, really good, and I'm very happy with that guy. This thing looks good in flying form, I think. I liked the gray ones better, but for one of the blue designed ones, it's nice to get the sand blue color in there. It's pretty authentic. I very much like the little Buzz Droid. That's a nice addition for a new design for this year. And it's always good to have something that transforms, but honestly, Lego, get back to me once you figure out how to make one of these that can actually walk. To me, the kind of scissor style leg design of, you know, actually being able to articulate the legs is really, really critical, key for a successful transforming Vulture Droid model. So to skip on that, to me, is a major miss. Also, the whole concept of having a pilot for a Vulture Droid, that doesn't sit well with me at all. It's fine for make pretend, but this is a licensed Star Wars set. You gotta do it right. The whole ship itself is a droid. It don't take no pilot. I think this is a cool set. I think it looks good in this form. It looks okay just standing in just a very static pose. I wish that they had made it cheaper though by leaving out some of the parts that were used to make the unnecessary cockpit. Even if they didn't put in the walking legs that I really would like to see, I still would have liked to see this whole thing just sold cheaper. Either that or keep it at this price and give us the ability to actually walk with it. But those are just my opinions. What are your opinions? What do you think about this set? Do you think it needs to be able to walk? What do you think about the whole idea of having a pilot in a Vulture Droid? Post up your opinions in the comments section. While you're doing that, I'm going to keep building more stuff and bringing you more reviews, so stay tuned, and I'll talk to you again soon.